In today's devotional reading, we come to the sixth chapter of the Gospel of Luke, and it is full of a whole lot of red. This is often known as the Beatitudes, some of the most enriching and illuminating teachings that Jesus ever gave. We find so much in here about how the Lord encourages us not to judge others, how you can really discern someone's life by the fruit that they're producing, and an exhortation to build our lives on the strong foundation of the Lord. But for this morning, here's one thing I find intriguing. Jesus calls us to be those that love. We know that, but not to just love those who love us, but to love our enemies. Let me read to you from the sixth chapter of the Gospel of Luke, starting around verse 32. If you love only those who love you, why should you get credit for that? Even sinners love those who love them. And if you do good only to those who do good to you, why should you get credit? Even sinners do that much. And if you lend money only to those who can repay you, why should you get credit? For even sinners will lend to other sinners for full return. Love your enemies. Do good to them. Lend to them without expecting to be repaid. Then your reward from heaven will be very great, and you will truly be acting as children of the Most High, for He is kind to those who are unthankful and wicked. You must be compassionate, just as your Father is compassionate. See, here's the amazing thing about being a believer. We actually show love to those that disagree with us on Facebook. We're actually kind to those that have a differing opinion than we do. See, we're called to love God and to love others. And Jesus is our example. For see, here's the deal. Jesus loved me even when I was His enemy. He hung on the cross for me, paid for my debt of sin, and restored me into a right relationship with God. He's done it for me. He's done it for us all. And in like manner, He calls us to love everyone authentically, genuinely, kindly, and compassionately, because that's who we are. We're the loved of God. So we then in turn love everyone, even our enemies.